the top five things I would like students to learn from the video, I would say number one is value. You separating your light and your shadow and getting that. That to me is the number one. Just not letting any of your lights get so dark they become shadow, and any of your darks get so light they become light. So that would be number one. Number two would be how, you know, since this is about backlighting and brushstroke, how to learn to deal with edges and what kind of strokes different brushes come up with. And I think I talked quite a few times about, you know, using the bristle brush, get more paint on, you can see the brush marks happening there. The sable brush, when you don't want as many brush marks, you want a little smoother finish happening with that. And then also how you put the brush down and lift it up to create the effect that you want. Three would be backlighting. I don't see as many artists do backlighting like I do backlighting. So I think it's important for students to have someone kind of showing them how to work with that, and how, you know, if you have strong backlighting from a warm light, that there's a warmth in the highlights, not just a cool white color, because that's the biggest mistake I usually see them doing. It's like, oh, that's white, so they just put straight white down. So this video is gonna show you how to give warmth and color depending on your light source for your subject. Four, I would say, is finding the color in your shadows, especially with light objects. Not just thinking your shadows are gray or a darker version than what's in the light. Really looking for something that's a lighter object, white, but other light objects do too. There's reflected light happening in them. So to be able to think of your subject in planes and what's hitting from above, what's hitting from the side, and what's hitting from underneath really helps. And I think in this video, that's gonna help you with that. Five, I would just say, you know, placement of your subject, composition. You know, we work on that as we decide how we're gonna lay out our subject, and make sure we're actually putting the drawing where we want it instead of where it just ends up.